Al Pacino and Robert De Niro duly power the momentum and large scale of this groundbreaking film, written and directed by Michael Mann. In the wake of a precision heist of an armored truck, an obsessive detective begins to hunt ruthless professional thief Neil McCauley through the streets of Los Angeles. As the stakes escalate, their lives begin to mirror and unravel, and McCauley's crew initiates his most dangerous and complex heist. Co-starring Val Kilmer, Tom Sizemore, Ashley Judd, Amy Brennerman, Natalie Portman, and John Voight, Heat delivers hard-hitting action, gripping suspense, and stunning performances. I never seen it in theaters. I watched it at home video, had the DVD, had the Blu-ray, now I had the 4K. And man, you know, you watch it the first time, you're like, okay, this movie was pretty good. You watch it a second time, okay, it's pretty great. You watch it a third time, awesome, epic. You watch it on 4K UHD, fantastic. I mean, this movie, it just keeps getting better the more you rewatch it and you kind of put the pieces together. This really is Michael Mann's his masterpiece. I mean, to be honest with you, as much as I love Thief, there's a lot of that in here. There's a lot of like real knowledgeable ways that you could rob things. And, you know, Michael Mann did his research, of course, talked to criminals and all that. The Heat project for Michael Mann has been a lifelong passion for him. I believe he even based a TV pilot off of an early draft of Heat. It's fascinating what he's done with this movie, casting Pacino and De Niro. First of all, it was an amazing score. We follow De Niro for a while, and we follow Pacino's character, who's after De Niro's character, and then they finally collide in that epic, masterful, masterclass of acting at the coffee scene. So Pacino pulls De Niro over and is like, "You want to get some coffee?" And so it's kind of like, they're not going to shoot each other. They try to understand each other, and I think they do come to that understanding. And as we go on throughout the film, and if you haven't seen the movie, highly recommend that you do. Every character has their motives, has their whole story, the whole backstory. It's all there. It's all laid out, whether it's through visuals or through the dialogue. We know these characters, and we start getting used to this world. You know, we start really rooting for McCauley's guys, you know, Robert De Niro's guys. You know, Val Kilmer is one of those guys that we root for, and his arc, his character arc with Ashley Judd as his wife and their relationship and their dynamic. Val Kilmer plays a character named Chris who happens to be a compulsive gambler. So he's got a lot of gambling demons and a lot of debts. So he's ready for the next score. You have Tom Sizemore is in here as part of the gang. And Danny Trejo, which I believe he plays the same. He plays a character named named Trejo. This movie has it all. And then not only that, it's like, the point man, the guy that gives McCauley the scores, is played by John Voight. And then there's Natalie Portman, who's on the Pacino side. He's on his third marriage. And this woman he's married to, she has a daughter, played by Natalie Portman. And they have a bond. They have a story arc. She has her own demons. She has her own issues. De Niro and Pacino's characters are so passionate and so work-driven. They have no time for personal attachments. And that's kind of McCauley's code. Don't have any attachments that you can't walk away within 30 seconds of sensing the heat around the corner. I butchered that, but that's the gist of it. Have no attachments. Pacino's character has no attachments because he's so work-obsessed with hunting these thieves, catching criminals, and putting them in the way. That's his passion. That's what he's married to. Married to the job. And I think when these characters meet at the for coffee, that really is the culmination of that. And then they break off, and it's such a rewarding, satisfying ending that it's an experience someday I hope to see in theaters. As far as the 4K UHD restoration, I think this film, in my opinion, has never looked better. Restoration was supervised by Michael Mann himself. I believe he even delayed the restoration for a certain time just to get it right. You know, it looks like a film print. It looks great. There's so much detail and dark and gritty. The movie is mostly at night. I want to say 80% of the movie is at night. So you have a lot of the dark tones and a lot of neon lights. And this movie really signals 90s LA in a unique fashion. You know, you see the underground of LA. You don't see the normal touristy places. You see the gritty streets of LA and the device culture of LA. There's that bank scene where they rob things, and the sound design of this movie It's not an Atmos track, but they kept the same sound design from the Blu-ray. And man, when that scene with the bank robbery, the gunshots, the echoing of the city, the fact that Michael Mann paid attention to so much detail, used the sound from the actual recording of gunshots live recorded into the microphone, it just takes it to another level. It adds another layer of believability and realism. I think that's what I appreciate most about Michael Mann's work, is he really puts the effort into the details, does his research. You know, cool steelbook, very basic, but what you get here is a wonderful restoration of an epic film. And if you haven't seen Heat, highly recommend it. Please go out and watch Heat and let me know what you thought of the 4K. This has been Return of the Disc. I'm Dan. For more Return of the Disc, visit returnofthedisc.com. Check out the audio version of today's show, available on all major podcast platforms. And be sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel.